My name is Benjamin Lebwohl. I'm a gastroenterologist and director of clinical research at the Celiac Disease Center at Columbia University. I'm a research grant awardee from the Celiac Disease Foundation. And I'd like to thank the Celiac Disease Foundation for giving me the opportunity to perform this research that addresses crucial issues related to quality of life and lifespan among people with celiac disease. I think that one of the central questions affecting celiac disease today is really, in one word, variability. How come there's so much variability in the outcomes that we're observing in people with celiac disease? Why is it that one person, after a diagnosis, starts the gluten-free diet and does fantastically well, whereas someone else, seemingly very much the same prior to a diagnosis, has so much difficulty, whether it's because of ongoing gluten exposure, or even if they are successful in avoiding gluten, they have ongoing symptoms, or they have consequences of celiac disease, whether it's bone-related problems like osteoporosis, or the rare cancer that we encounter in celiac disease. Why is there so much variability? And to better understand that, we need to study the different life courses that people take after a diagnosis of celiac disease. In terms of what's necessary to answer these crucial questions, we need more funding for high-quality population-based research in celiac disease. So for example, today there are 3 million Americans with celiac disease, and we can do our best to take care of them one by one, but to really advance their care, we need to study large groups. We need to understand why some people do great and other people have difficulty. For example, using funds from the Celiac Disease Foundation, we are doing population-based research on every patient in Sweden with celiac disease for whom we're able to map out who lives a long, healthy life and whose life expectancy is curtailed by celiac disease, whether because of cancer, heart disease, fracture, or other complications. We need to better understand who is at risk for having their life expectancy affected by these complications so that we can bring back these answers to the United States, apply them to the individuals who we're taking care of, and improve their quantity and quality of life. I'd like to thank the Celiac Disease Foundation for giving me the opportunity to perform this research and address questions that are crucial to the celiac disease community.